Okay, so let's add some tone to Captain America's shield here. It's really simple. Let's take a look at the pencils. The penciler, he's got these lines in here for like the shine of the shield, which looks great. I wanted to use a tone for it because I wanted it to look really smooth. I think if I were to do it by hand, it would probably, I wouldn't get the result that I'm looking for. So there's two ways to make a tone or to add tones to your art. One way I don't really use very much because I always just do it this way, the way I'm going to show you. So let's start by making a selection. And it doesn't matter what layer you have on because when you click over to tone, it makes its own layer. So I want it right in here and like this. Okay. When you have that, you've got your options underneath. And here is add new tone. So then you get this dialog box. So the first thing we look at is what type we want. I want lines, and I want the lines going this way, which is great because you can adjust the angle. So if you want the lines to go any way, you know, you can change it to match your art. I think mine was 119. Frequency is how often. And density, I have it set to 20, but density basically is how thick what you have is. So I put mine at 20. Now you're probably looking at this thinking, wow, that's pretty far apart. And well, that's for two reasons. One, because this is a preview and it's a little bigger. Two, my art is 11 by 17. That's typically how I work because that's how comic book pages are. And then everything is shrunk down to your standard size. So if these are too close together right now, I would be afraid that when this is shrunk down and printed, if it were a page or a cover, that it would get muddy. That's why I kind of keep it a little bit further apart. This might be more than I normally would because of the shield and everything, but that's what I have. With circles, that's basically your dots. I would probably have put this somewhere around 27 and a half. But let's go back to 15 and go back to the lines. Click OK. And then you have your tone on your page. And what it did was it made an entire layer of your tone. And then it masked off everything but what you had selected. Which means you can go in with a pen. You can see I didn't go right to the edge on the shield, so we can fix that. With any one of these selected, the black or the white, you can draw back in your tone. Or, in a second I'll show you. Let's do that, and then let's get another one in there and bring that down. I don't like this right there. So what you can do to remove it is go to your transparent, which then can erase. So you can also add and erase tone on your layer, which is really cool. So let's say I wanted to add another swoop down here on the bottom. So I would just go back to here. And what's great is that if you draw tone the way you want it and you keep that line going, oops, that's okay, I can get rid of that. We're on a different layer. And then you go to your fill, it'll fill that. So let's go back to the pen, and I don't want it in that shine because it doesn't really make sense. Turn off the pencils, and there you go. But let me show you some of the other times I've used tone in the past and how that would look. Here's a page from Tales of the Dark Tunnel. And I added this tone here for a shadow. And then over here, another page from Tales of the Dark Tunnel, I used the noise option, which is great for like dirt and stone, maybe marble, just, you know, something gritty. It's just got a great look to it. But let's go back to cap, and I'll show you one more neat feature of the tone, layer. You can select it here. Go to layer properties. Now, if you don't have that, if you can't find this window, that's easy to find. You go to window. Sorry, I'm off the screen. And you click it, and it's right there. Now, mine has a check in front of it because my window is open. And that's how you'd find it. So you go in here, and you will see that all the settings we were taught that we did when we first made the selection in the pop-up is right here. So if you decide, you know, that maybe that frequency was not enough, you can change that. Maybe the density needs to be more, maybe it needs to be less. You can also change what you have, like noise. That looks, see, with noise, I like to make it a, you know, a little, there we go. That looks nice. Or you can change it to cross. Now cross, it's not what you think it is. It's more like a cross pattern. It's not like little crosses. The other feature of the tone layer is you can change its color. Right now the tone is on top of the ink layer, and that's why you can see over it, and that wouldn't make much sense. But if you just dragged it down below, then it's down below. And you can also change the color here. So let's say you wanted it to be, you know, magenta. Great. There's a lot of options with this, a lot of great effects you can make. Or you could just keep it simple like I did and just do, you know, shadows or shines. All right, that is it for this video. Thanks for watching. I have a link in my description about Gumroad. I've got some free brushes you can check out. I also have a link to Clip Studio Paint. If it's something you're interested in getting, if you use that link and you buy something, I get a small percentage. It helps the channel, helps me make more of these videos. So until the next video, thanks much and see you later.